Welcome back to my channel. So if you've clicked on this video because you watched the first one where I describe why you should go skydiving, the one up here, and you're still not convinced, I'm hoping that this video is the one that will push you to book your skydive. And I feel like it's time for me to make a second video to encourage those of you who are looking to do skydive or have been meaning to do skydive, that this one is gonna be the one that honestly solidifies your plans, because I feel like that first one, I left out some very important details that explain why skydiving doesn't feel like a roller coaster. So I also want to do this as well because I actually did my second skydive on August 30th, 2020. And thankfully I had friends this time to join me, because the first time I did it, I was by myself. This time I had three good friends who honestly have been wanting to skydive, and I thought, sure, I'll go again for some moral support. Why not? But for now, I'm gonna try to convince you. Hopefully this is going to ease your mind a little bit more than the first one, and it will help you understand why skydiving isn't as scary as you may think it is. So to start off, I wanna say that it is totally normal to feel nervous, because even though I went on my second skydive, I was still slightly nervous because it had been 4 years, I believe, since I did my first initial jump. But to get into details to why skydiving is nowhere close to a roller coaster is, if you think about it, when you're on the airplane actually goes at a very high speed. I could be wrong with these numbers, but from what I saw, it's around 100 miles per hour, roughly. Correct me if I'm wrong, but let's just say it's 100 miles per hour that the airplane goes. So when your body goes to jump out of the plane, for it to reach terminal velocity with your tandem master, I don't know what they're called, tandem jumpers, the person who's strapped on with you, for your body to reach terminal velocity, it takes seconds. And the reason is because terminal velocity, depending on the weight of yourself and the instructor, it could be anywhere between like 120 miles per hour or more. So if your airplane is already going 100 miles per hour and terminal velocity for you is 120 miles per hour, that means your body needs to adjust 20 miles faster for your body to reach terminal velocity, which is basically feeling like nothing. So the adjustment from you on the plane to out of the plane to free fall literally takes seconds for your body to adjust, which is why you don't feel the stomach dropping feeling that you get when you're on a roller coaster. Now, if you put yourself in a roller coaster in comparison, you're sitting in a ride, you're strapped in, and you work your way up to that first drop. That first drop, when you're up there, you know they hold that position for a bit before they actually let you go. And when you're in that position, you're going no speed at all. So when your roller coaster decides to drop you, not only is it pushing you down this drop, it is unnaturally pushing your body a certain speed down the drop. So it's not like when you're jumping out of an airplane where it's just natural gravity pushing your weight and the instructor's weight to adjust to terminal velocity. There's multiple factors as to why your stomach feels the way it does when you're on a roller coaster. Again, it's forcing you to go a certain speed. There's a lot of twists and turns and loops and drops and whatever. So your body's constantly adjusting to different speeds, different directions. So your organs are being pushed around, and that is why you feel the things that you feel when you're on a roller coaster. Whereas when you're skydiving, you're going one direction only, and no one's forcing you to go down but gravity, and that is natural. It's gravity just letting your body fall through the sky, which is also very terrifying, but it's really nothing at all. It feels like you are, I don't wanna say floating, because it's not necessarily floating either, but because there's a lot of wind, but it doesn't feel like you're dropping. It honestly just feels like you're nothing, like literally nothing. I can't explain it, I can't describe it. The only cues that you're getting that you're falling is the wind, and that's about it. And that's the only thing, because there's nothing happening in your body where you feel it, which is crazy. And that's also why I don't have any plans to bungee jump, because bungee jumping is kind of the same idea as a roller coaster. You're staying at the edge of a cliff, you are staying at the edge of a bridge, strapped in, whatever, going no speed, and then you're dropping your body. So that, again, is your body going from 0 to 100, but because you're jumping at such a low height with bungee jumping, you're gonna feel that drop. And not only that, when you drop, the bungee cord pulls you back up. So it's changing direction, and then it's dropping you again, which is changing direction again. and so bungee jumping is definitely not in my books. But if you guys have gone bungee jumping and you liked it, skydiving is gonna be nothing for you. And same with roller coasters. If you like roller coasters, skydiving is gonna be a breeze for you. At least in my opinion, because I never liked roller coasters. The only roller coaster I honestly was okay with as a child was Disney World, riding Rock and Roll Roller Coaster and Space Mountain. And Space Mountain, I was still a little terrified, but those roller coasters are indoor, so I can't see where I'm going. So I was fairly okay with those, even though it was still not as pleasant in some drops and turns, whatever. But those ones I prefer because I can't see how high I am, and I can't see where this roller coaster is going. And that's actually also another reason why roller coasters are kind of scary, is because there's like the changing directions and speed and course and all that stuff, but there's also visual cues. Like, you can see how high, how fast you are, like, literally about to hit the ground, and there's just a lot of stuff happening. Whereas, like I said in the first video where I describe it, when you're falling at 11,000, 12,000, 13,000 feet, you are too high for your brain to comprehend how high you are. So when you're falling, like, even when the parachute is being pulled, you still are so high up and you can't see people on the ground. You can see cars, but it's not like a roller coaster where you're at a height where you can literally see people walking around, and I just feel like that's a little bit more terrifying. So yeah, I hope that makes sense. Give this video a thumbs up right now if you felt like that was a great description as to why skydiving doesn't feel like a roller coaster. And if it doesn't, then maybe I'll do a third video 4 years from now, who knows. But I'm hoping that is enough to explain to you why skydiving is not as scary as you think it is. And I'd like people to, you know, if you have plans to skydiving or you want to do something exciting this year, or eventually do something exciting when you graduate for milestones and stuff like that, like, don't hold yourself back. Obviously there are risks to doing stuff like this, so that's something you do have to understand. And personally, to me, I feel like skydiving, in comparison to other things like driving cars, the risk is fairly low and the chances of you getting into an accident is very low. The people who are doing these tandem jumps, especially if you're doing your research, are doing so many jumps in one day, 1 week, whatever, that they've got this like the back of their hands. They do it for a living. They live and breathe skydiving. It's just something that they love doing. So it's like taking a walk through a park for them. So yeah, I mean, like I said, of course there are some chances that you're risking some potential injuries depending on how things go. If you are like me and you are in a position where you want to go, I really, really hope that you do it, and yeah, that you try it out. And let me know in the comments below if you do try it and the description of the skydive is accurate. Honestly, when you're doing the free fall, it just feels like wind is blowing at your body. Like, you don't feel the fall. The other parts I would say is like the parachute part of the skydive, that you would potentially feel like a slight drop, because I know the tandem masters are trying to get back to the drop zone area. So if they do have to change directions and like maybe speed up the process, or like, you know, stay on schedule or whatever, sometimes they do like a spiral. That's the only time I'd say is the closest thing to a roller coaster, even though it's nowhere close, but like you do feel like a slight drop there if you're in the parachute. But aside from that, honestly, it's such a breeze. It's so much fun. You're literally running on adrenaline when you get to the ground. It's so much fun. You immediately, at least for me, you want to do it again. And you know, it's crazy to think that you just skydive X amount of feet from the sky. Like, not many people do that. So go in skydive if you're considering something, especially because I know the season is ending, at least for us here in Canada. If you live down in the States in a warmer area, definitely go try it out and let me know what you think. If this video is helpful to you, please give it a thumbs up to let me know. Subscribe to my channel for more, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.